Naimbanga Aksapa Montañosa, and welcome to the show where we talk about relevant matters surrounding our Ili Aykalalaychan Mountain Province. This is the show where we get to listen, learn, and be informed of not only the government agencies' programs, projects, and activities, but understand insights from our private sectors as well. Kaya huwag na natin pahabain pa, kakailian, tawag mo.
We can go to a different world. We can go to a different world.
More and more youth in this generation has willingly taken the step towards community involvement, thus proving the saying of our national hero, Dr. Jose Rizal, Kabataan ang pag-asa ng bayan. Welcome everyone to Intaku Amun, the PIA Mountain Province Talk Show in its third episode. Sa ngalan po ng aming secretary na si Secretary Cheloy Garafil, our Director General Jose A. Torres Jr., and of course, our regional head, Ma'am Helen Tibaldo. Good morning po. My name is Valerie Taguba, your host for today's episode. And as I have mentioned nga po kanina, the youth right now, particularly the youth of Mountain Province, has been making a noise lately, but in a positive way. Contrary to what most of us think na yung mga kabataan po is puro lang sila mga nagkakos ng violence or addicts sa mga mobile games and whatnot, the Imontanyosa youth is anything but. Now from being active members ng kanikanila pong mga youth organization and of course to their community, that is also on being part din po ng mga organization that is geared towards development or self-development through community involvement, these youths, they are ready po to take the helm and drive this generation to a future that is centered with mental, emotional, and of course, above all else, spiritual growth. And we have invited one of those youth po to be our guest for today's episode. Here to share to us what her organization is all about, and of course, many more na pag-uusapan po natin in this episode. We have here, and let us all welcome, the President of the Kabataan Contra Droga at Terorismo Mountain Province Chapter, Ma'am Kashmir Nicole Pascual. Good morning, Ma.
Good morning to Ma'am Valerie.
So, kumusta naman tayo? Kumusta ang pakiramdam ng being youth leader, di ba?
Of course, na we are alive. Alive meaning happy tayo kasi andito tayo sa organization na to, which is on to helping sa mga youth natin.
Ayun. So, di na po natin to patatagalin. Let us dive into the topic on ano nga ba tong KKDOT? Ma'am, if you could share to us kung what is KKDOT, you can include po yung as your history niya at the same time kung ano mga objectives ng ating organization.
Okay, so KKDOT, as mentioned by Ma'am Valerie, stands for Kabataan Contra Droga at Terorismo, which was launched on February 1, 2019. Okay, so during those times before 2019, so there are many issues kasi on our youth, which is very, sa government natin, they need to address. So one of addressing these issues on illegal drugs and terrorism is to organize the Kabataan Contra Droga at Terorismo. So, KKDOT intends to inform, inform in a way na awareness on the effects of joining terrorist activities and on the abusing yourself into illegal drugs. Mm-mm. And another thing is to organize. So yung organize is yung KKDOT mismo. So we are organized, we have officers, we have also members. And sa mobilization, so we the KKDOT are mobilized through the police community relations, programs, and platforms of the PNP.
Uh-oh.
Okay, so another is to also inflame yung spirit of voluntarism ng mga youth. Kasi dito, we are not on to the parang pinapressure yung mga youth to join us, but for them to realize kung ano nga ba ang naitutulong or ng KKDOT sa ating community. And lastly is to empower them para maging proactive partner ng government into the nationwide cascading ng advocacies onto anti-illegal drugs and anti-terrorism.
Ayun. So may madami tayong mga ano no, mga agenda or parang guiding post siguro ng KK that,
yes,
no. So sa Mountain Province, if you have ma'am the data, ilan po ba yung mga members, active members natin ng KKTAT, including siguro sa, basta yung pool,
Mount Everest? So whole, yung lately na-update is 500.
Wow!
But then, of course, medyo, yung iba kasi hindi na sila active. So, you can say na 200 active members. Kasi yung iba sa amin is estudyante. So, nahihirapan kami sa time management.
Yes.
But then, we are still on finding our time para makapag-conduct ng activities.
But still, 200 is, ano, pag na-mobilize lahat yan, ganda si, ganda,
yes,
yun. So, I understand na ang KKDOT Mountain Province is hindi lang siya like a whole organization, pero parang I think segmented siya into KKDOT per municipality.
Yes.
Why is that? Bakit tayo may KKDOT per municipio?
Yun na nga, KKDOT Mountain Province is hindi niya kayang mag-cater ng mga members or activities which is na nakakandak per municipio, sa per chapter sana. So, naisip ng mga kapulisan why not form or KKDOT chapter on the municipio mismo para at least doon sa kanilang munisipyo, they can conduct activities na sa alam nila is nababagay doon sa community mismo. And para na rin ma-engage yung community doon sa municipality. And also, sa implementation of activities siguro, mas ma-allocate nila kung ano yung mga kailangang resources to conduct yung activities na hindi nagagampanan ng the whole, yung mother organization. And since nationwide, so yun, include yung mga barangay, municipality, ganun po.
Oh, so ganun pala yun. Para siyang, if ever sa mga national agencies, meron pa yung parang to the grassroots level din na connection, if ever. No? So, since you are here na rin lang, tanungin na lang din natin, like, you being the president of this esteemed, sabihin na natin na, esteemed organization, what's your experience? Siguro from the time na pumasok ka, paano ba yung ano? How was the treatment ng mga kapulisan towards the organization and to you then as a member?
Maganda naman siya. Nung first, na-curious ako ano nga ba ang KKDOT. Kasi yung acronym lang. But then, as I go on, nung na-mobilize na ako, nag-join na ako sa mga activities nila, maganda pala siya. Kasi more on community engagement, socialization sa mga youths din na katulad namin. And malalaman mo rin doon yung mga different issues na hinaharap ng mga kabataan, which is through joining sa KKDOT is parang na-address mo na rin yung issue na yun. And treatment ng police, welcome naman sila. They are welcome naman nila kami every time we go to their office for partnership. And of course, minsan din naman, they are also helping us para sa fundraising ng organization.
So may fundraising tayo na,
yes.
May mga, ano pa ba yung mga activities natin na kinakandak under the KKDOT?
So we are, lately we have conducted yung KKDOT Fellowship. Which is one of our fundraising activity na din. And variety show, which is conducted by the KKDOT Bontoc chapter.
Oh.
And also, yung, anong tawag dito? Sa Unity Walk and Peace Signing Covenant, December 26. And sa mga, per chapter is yung mga initiatives nila, which is on tree planting, clean up drives, walk for a cause, yung mga ganun. So kung titingnan natin is yung mga KKDOT chapter is yung kanila parang sila yung workforce namin.
Oo, ayun. Mm-hmm. So on your, since kailan ka pala nag-start or kailan ka pumasok as KK.Member?
KK.Member, I think mga 2021.
So 21, 22, 23, 24. Sabihin natin, 3 years.
Oo.
Sa 3 years na pagiging part mo of the KK.Member, on your personal mm-hmm. opinion lang naman siya or personal point of view, ano yung mga misconceptions na hindi na parang na-receive ng mga KK.Members or na-receive mo yung mga misconception or parang mali na naririnig mo towards the KK.Member?
Hindi, of course, hindi yan may iwasan sa mga organizations kasi nga siguro mismo yung mga members rin ang gumagawa ng mga misconceptions, which is leading rin sa sinasabi ng iba. So, for now, yung mga naririnig namin is for, kasi students lahat, so sa parents nila, hindi sila nag, minsan hindi sila nakumukuha ng parents' consent on attending the activities. But then, of course, siguro kasi yung concern ng mga members namin is kapag they ask for the permission of the parent, di sila papayagan.
Mm-mm.
So sometimes they just go without even the permission of a parent. So yun yung isang issue, which is hindi magandang kwan kasi dapat, lalo na ngayon, we have to, kung saan tayo pupunta, we have to tell our parents kasi na. Diba yung issue ngayon is more on the missing trauma. So yun po yung isang issue, yun lang naman yung isang concern.
Ayun, so since na-mention natin yung concern, ano ba yung benefit na makukuha ng mga youth members or mga younger generation pag nag-enter sila, siguro kahit hindi mga youth organizations, particularly sa KK.Member?
Okay, so i-relate ko na lang sa as for my experience, more on the practical skills na which is magagamit natin in the future when we work, college, when we are, sa akin kasi is develop ko yung aking communication, social, kasi we are more on to yun nga, in joining the MYPDs, we are more on to socializing sa mga students, youths na tulad namin. And also leadership, kasi dito na de-develop or ne-enhance yung leadership kasi when we initiate activities or yes, activities, nakikipartner din kami sa mga agencies like BFP, sa PNP mismo, sa mga other line agencies. So we need yung confidence, yung leadership na kailangan matuloy to, matuloy ganun. So, and another is critical thinking or yung problem solving. Kasi nga sa organization, hindi maiwasan yung mga may dadating na issues, problema. So from that, we can think kung ano ba yung mas magandang solution para mas ma-improve, ma-enhance natin yung mga members natin na maging active at maibigay nila yung kanilang dedication onto the organization.
Ayun. So madami talagang mano. Pero that is just some, no? Parang on your behalf is yun yung mga natutunan mo. How much more kapag pumasok talaga yung mga others. Kasi I think, and I believe din naman, since I have been attending yung mga some activities under the KK, that yung mga ino-organize ninyo, that a lot of people, they learn a lot of things from your organization. So in that, segue ko na lang din, paano ba tayo makakapasok sa KK.Member?
Okay, so to join our organization, you just have these 3 qualifications.
Mm-hmm.
So you must be 15 to 30 years old. So papasok ka, you have to be 15. But then sa mga cases kasi may mga nagjo-join na under 15 years old. Mm. So we still accept them. And you go out when you are 30 years old. So, yun po.
yun kasi yung, yung youth na age, I think, is yung 30 yung cut-off.
Oo, pero kung gusto mo pa rin mag-join, you can continue naman. And We are also giving membership form for them to fill in yung mga informations. Mm-hmm. Of course, para malaman din namin yung kanilang personal background, family background.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And lastly is a membership fee of 50 pesos. So this is hindi naman siya mandatory but voluntary.
Mm-mm.
Kasi nga student kami,
oh,
yung mga members namin. So yung 50 pesos is serves as a starting fund for our organization.
Ayun. Mm-hmm. So ayun din, buti na na-mention mo na student and you are a student.
Yes,
right
po.
Now MPSPC, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes po.
Anong MPSPC course na tinitake mo natin doon?
So I am taking Bachelor of Secondary Education, major in English po.
Ayun. So hi po sa mga MPSPC students natin dyan and of course our instructors as well. So now that na-mention mo na estudyante ka, how do you juggle yung commitment mo as the president of the KK that and of course yung commitment mo as a student ng MPSPC or as a student in general?
Mm-hmm. So juggling is it takes time management. So mm-hmm. for me kasi full anong tawag dito? Full time schedule yung class ko, so I need to of course balance muna. So I focus more on my class. And then pag during vacation, some breaks, we can have activities as far as we are all available. Kasi kung hindi rin naman available yung mga members natin, hindi naman available. But then, mga kikiba chapter naman, sila yung parang sumasalo sa amin, yung mother organization. Kakandas sila ng
activity. That is nice. Oo, yun yung importante kasi kailangan, nasimulan nyo na to eh. So, kailangan dire-diretso na to. Yes. So, earlier na-mention mo na parang, I think, the PNP, ang, I guess, paano ba natin sabi ito? Partner siya. And in a way, parang sila din yung parang nag-organize, if I'm not mistaken, sa KK Dot. So here, of course, madami tayong mga KK Dot since this is a national organization. Merong from different provinces and of course, dito rin sa region natin, madami yan. Here in Mountain Province, and again, this is just your opinion, yung experience mo siya, na-mention mo na maganda yung pakikitungo ng ating mga kapulisan. Now, question is, paano naman yung pag-guide nila sa inyo to achieve yung mga goals and aim of the KK Dot? Yes.
So, meron kaming mga advisors. Mm-hmm. So, sila yung advisors namin on they are the ones guiding us.
Ah, sino pala yung advisor natin sa Mountain Province, KK Dot Mountain Province?
So, our advisor is other than Sir Calvino.
Hi, sir.
Hello, sir.
Sana manood ka.
Okay, so siya po yung advisor namin together with Sir Jeremiah.
Hi, Sir Maya.
And yun po. So, in the matter of funding us, so parang hinahayaan nila kami for us to be independent kasi yung labas lang naman nila. Or sabi na nila, they are just our advisor na mag-guide sa amin kung tama ba yung ginagawa namin or hindi. So, yun po. So, yung, when it comes to advices naman nila is, they are focusing on yung mas nakaka-benefit sa amin.
So, mabait naman.
Mabait naman sila. Of course, they need to balance mabait and then, anong tawag ito? Strict. Walang turba-turbanism.
Oo, yung hindi masyadong ano, di nyo na in-overstep yung boundary ninyo na parang binabody-body nyo na lang sila. Na parang wala ng direction yung organization ninyo. So, na-mention natin yung mga activities, no? Baka may other activities ba kayo? Especially sana yung mga kayo mismo yung nag-initiate apart from the apart from the tree planting, because I think, I'm not sure if I may be wrong, pero Natonin, KK Dot Natonin, is they have organized this community involvement na mga, they go into the community para mag-conduct ng siguro outreach program. The same ba sa lahat ng mga KK Dot across municipalities?
Yes,
For now, yung kaya that person is isa yung sa mga nag-join ng outreach.
Mm-hmm.
Yung iba naman kasi is siguro, they are still on to organizing.
Yeah.
So, really much organizing kaya that. Sa mga own initiative namin is yun na yung kaya that fellowship.
Mm-hmm.
Unity Walk and Peace Sign and Covenant. And sa future activities namin, is on to the, we are planning to the vaccine by the time.
Oh!
Yes, wala pa mong exact time kasi ongoing pa yung preparation ng mga first actors. So, we're still on queue kung kailan na maganap. And advocacy sessions.
Ayun.
Kasi kailangan namin yung siguro kasi yung phase kasi ng Kiki that is may three phases. So, phase one is yung awareness.
Uh-huh.
So, isang ginagawa ng mga PNP on to spreading awareness is yung kakanap sila ng NYPD.
Uh-huh.
And then from that, if graduate na sila ng NYPD, they encourage them to join sa KKDA. And then sa mobilization, which is so, we need yung advocacy session kasi yung ibang mga members natin is hindi sila graduate ng MIT. So, hindi nila alam kung ano yung nangyayari sa KKDA. So, we need them to recall or to inform them kung ano nga ba ang nangyayari sa KKDA. So, we need advocacy session.
So, that's yung may faces din talaga ang KKDA. Okay, so moving forward nga rin po. Nyor, again, sa pananaw mo, no? What is the effect of having KKDOT per municipality and of course KKDOT Mountain Province sa buong to the community as a whole then?
This will yung KKDOT kasi is more on the youth sector, so at least sa youth sector may nagagawa kaming tulong to address yung mga issues of youths. Especially kasi na yung mga kabataan. Madali silang nalilinaw sa mga illegal
activities,
which is through this initiative program, we are helping the government into spread sa kanilang advocacy, which is onto anti-legal drugs and anti-
Ayun. So at least may benefit and at the same time talaga may tulong siya sa community. Alright, so for our final question, like ano na lang yung message mo sa ating mga fellow youth? You could invite them to be part of the KKDOT sa mga respective municipalities nila. Kung ano man yung other things that you still want to share with regard to KKDOT.
So, sa mga youths out there, so I encourage you to join sa ating KKDOT, of course, para mas marami tayo, mas marami matutunan. So, sabi na ni Jose Rizal, mentioned by the way, tayo ang pag-asa ng bayan. So, through joining KKDOT, we can be an agent of change to our community, sa ating bayan, which is Pilipinas. And of course, through this, marami naman tayong matutunan. Hindi naman on to the more on leadership, but then you can learn also things which is nakakatulong sa mga sa ating pag-aaral, which is a training ground for us para maging prepared na use sa pagharap ng kinabukasan. So, and live,
laugh, love. Ayun, live, laugh, love. So there you have it, mga kakailian ninyo. That has been the KKDOT President or KKDOT Mountain Province President, Ma'am Nicole, Kashmir Nicole Pascual. Taga kasan po ka to?
From Bontoc.
Ayun, from Bontoc Mountain Province. And there you have it. That wraps our third episode of Intakuamuan, the PIA Mountain Province Talk Show. And before I end, I encourage everyone po to please like and follow PIA Mountain Province. And of course, lahat po ng mga KKDOT municipality Facebook pages po is there are official. You could go ahead po and follow because ang dami po nilang mga activities and it would also help po na to prove nga po na yung point natin here na yung kabataan here in Mountain Provinces, they are doing something to change the perception of the community na puro lang po sila ayon ML or puro lang sila mga causing of trouble or even being the root cause of violence. So go ahead po and check their Facebook pages and be part din po sa mga community or mga tree planting nila. I think may mga ongoing tree planting or may mga scheduled tree planting sila. Be part of that and take part din po ng mga activities. Of course, i-plug na rin po natin yung mga activities din po ng PNP since they are the advisors of our KKDOT. May mga tree planting activities din po ang PNP and very rightful po na this month is as well the Police Community Relations Month. So there you have it. And this has been your host. I am Valerie Taguba of the PIA Mountain Province. See you all in the fourth episode of Intaku Amun. Bye! We can go to a different world. We can go to a different